Well, good evening, church. We are so glad to have you here tonight joining us for this special time with the Joy Singers Choir, a wonderful group that is ready to praise the Lord and share a great message of Jesus' birth and the wonderful story of God's love for us.
I'd like to start by reading from the Old Testament book of Isaiah, chapter 7 and verse 17. It says, "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel."
Luke 1:26-33. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting that might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end."
Thank you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and our daughters? Did you know that your baby boy had come to make you new? And this child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the sea with his hand? And did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you've kissed your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises are. That your baby boy is Lord of all creation. And Mary, did you know that your baby boy will someday rule all the nations? And did you know heaven's perfect plan? And that sleeping child you're holding, he's the great
days. Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in the manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, heaven and earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests."
Have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Yeah. Luke 2:15-16. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger.
Shepherds had seen the child, they spread the word concerning all that the angels had told them, and all who heard it were amazed.
Down and on the mountain, over the hill. John 1, 9 to 12 and 3:16, the true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
How can I thank you enough? How can I thank you enough? You've been so good to me, it's hard for me to see. How can I thank you enough? Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost.
In answer to that question, I don't think we can thank him enough, but y'all come pretty close on that song. Amen? Amen. I just want to share a devotional thought with you tonight to close our services. I had a lot of thoughts as I was sitting there listening to what they did. And the thing that I like best about this group is you just never know. when they brought out the cowboy hats, I was, okay, this is good. I was a cowboy lover from way back. But anyway, the thing that I got from this presentation was not only from the scriptures about the fact that Jesus came the first time and that he's coming again, is that you just really never know what to expect. Luke 2:11 says, "For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." They had expected the Messiah to come. They really didn't know. They really hadn't grasped what he was actually coming to do that first time. But one of the things that we need to understand is that Jesus was born in Bethlehem, and it was only about 8 miles to where he was crucified at Calvary. 8 miles. 8 miles between the first birth at Bethlehem in the manger and the second birth. He rose from the dead and showed us how to be born again ourselves. So from the tomb to the manger wasn't that far. And you know, you really can't think of Bethlehem without also thinking of the cross in Jerusalem. Because that's who Jesus came to be, our Lord and our Savior. And I bet you, as Don sang that song, Mary, Did You Know? I mean, she knew it was going to be God's son, but I don't think there was any way she could know that he was going to do all the things that Don mentioned in that song that he was singing, that he was going to walk on water, that he was going to be raised from the dead. Yeah, I just don't think she could have ever known that. A baby born in a manger and a lamb who was sacrificed on a cross, 8 miles apart, but you can't think of one without the other. And that, Charlie Brown, is what Christmas is really all about. Would you all stand with me, please, and let's have a word of prayer before we are dismissed tonight. Father, thank you for this opportunity that we've had to hear this beautiful music and hear the message in each and every song, sung in different styles. And Father, we just thank you for the privilege of celebrating the birth of our Savior and looking forward to the time when he comes back to see us again and right all of the wrong things in this world. And so, Father, I pray that if there's anybody here that has heard and the message, that tonight, if they don't know that this baby that we celebrate coming to be born in a manger grew up to be the Savior who died on the cross to give us the opportunity to have new birth, that they right now, as we are praying, would simply say, Dear Lord Jesus, I call on your name to be saved. You said, Whosoever calleth upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. I'm calling on your name, Jesus. Please save me right now. Come into my life and save me so that I can live the rest of my life with you and for you. So, Lord, I pray for everybody here that they can move from what they heard and learned in their heads tonight and make that real in their heart. And when you think about it, it's really not that far, but it will last for an eternity. Thank you, Jesus, for coming. Thank you for coming again. We look forward to it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.